This was the number three this week. Is a new entry for Janet Jackson. It's called All For You.
This is the lead single from her seventh studio album.
Yeah.
And actually the 10th and last US number one that we see from Janet.
Mm.
She came to the UK, did it on CD UK, she did it on Top of the Pops.
The comparisons here are interesting because much like Kylie, Janet also had an album in 1997 that was considered quite different to the back catalogues to this point. The album that Janet brought out was The Velvet Rope, which, unlike Kylie's Impossible Princess, was critically acclaimed. I think Kylie's album was kind of more divisive.
Yeah.
People weren't so sure whether it was a success or not. Whereas, you know, Janet comes in All For You off the back of what's seen by many as one of the definitive albums of the 90s because it explored some taboo subjects. It was quite deep and dark. It was quite sexy, but in a kind of kinky way, not conventionally sort of sexy. Janet's coming into this one in a very similar position to Kylie for me, of like, she's just gonna come and blow the pop charts away again. She's had the fun with the experimental stuff.
Yeah.
Now she's here just to let rip and do some disco, do some pop. What can you say? Overwhelming success. I hope you agree. Please say you agree.
Well, so whenever I saw it coming, a bit underwhelmed. Together Again was my favourite Janet Jackson track in my head.
Right.
And then whenever I pressed play on this, I was a bit like, oh my God, this is huge.
Yes.
I forgot how big this was. I was not excited to listen to this track at all. And I remember it just being so shocking at the time, because we were like, has she really just said, you've got a nice package, all right, I think I'm going to have to write it tonight? And does that mean what it actually means in my head?
Funny you should say that, because the website Genius, which I always love because it tends to break down certain lines of tracks that need a bit more explanation. And I looked on this one and they have actually put an annotation for that line, got a nice package, all right, guess I'm gonna have to write tonight. The interpretation from Genius is, and this shouldn't be a surprise if it is, grow up, Janet is talking about a man's penis when she refers to his package. Her wanting to write it suggests that she wants to have plans to sex with this man. It's just like, yeah, we just any ambiguity removed. It wasn't any kind of, it wasn't about DPD delivery service. It was indeed about getting it on.
Yeah, that's so strange. So overall, the whole song is like just a song around Janet's outlook on dating and kind of instructions from her to not be intimidated by her and by her fame.
Mm.
But it's so strange. This song reminds me of whenever, I think, is it, did we get to 2003? Whenever Blue Too Close comes out? I think it's 2003.
Yes.
I was hanging out with my friend Sarah Blair, and I think I've said this before, where Sarah was singing, baby, when we're grinding. And she's like, what does that even mean? I was like, Sarah, I think it's about dry humping on someone when you're dancing. And she was like, no, it isn't. And I was like, what did you think Janet Jackson's got a nice package, all right, thing, I'm going to have to write it tonight, man? And she was like, no. And then, you know, like, Sarah was very well behaved, and whenever you think that Sarah is going to be like, I'm not singing that song anymore, Sarah just got a bit friskier in her dance routines whenever she was singing these songs. But such an erotic song.
Yes.
It's happy, it's fun, it's sexy, it's upbeat, it is naughty, which is what I love about it. It's like, it's naughty, it's not too naughty. Can't believe that I'm sitting here bigging up the JJ.
It's interesting because, I mean, you say it's happy and it's upbeat and it's positive and it's sexy. This record, this album, came off the back of a divorce from a secret 9-year marriage.
Weird.
Isn't that so strange? She's been married to someone for 9 years, told nobody. People find out because she's got divorced, and this is the next single that comes out. This positive, joyous, sexy disco number. I mean, she's stronger than I'd be. I mean, if I'd been in a 9-year marriage and then got divorced, my track that I brought out would not sound like this.
No, is this code that the guy she was married to for 9 years had a minging package because she was just like, you've got a minging package, all right, I'm definitely not going to ride that tonight.
It's definitely some way to put yourself back on the market, isn't it?
It really is. And I actually remember watching the video to this over and over again when I was younger, because it had a virtual train platform. So you've got like this whole weird 2D world. And I remember watching it thinking, this is so cosmopolitan to me. You know, I'm a country bumpkin, really.
Yeah.
And like now I've made it because I get to frequently ride the Tiny Weir metro system. I am practically I'm practically Janet Jackson.
You're like, living the life of luxury.
I totally am. You know, even whenever the door closes, it goes, Mm-hmm. Yeah. But at the time, this was all about the ripped jeans. We have a music video which has got Volkswagen Beetles in it, which we've said, like, we've got X5s on the go, we've got Z3s on the go, and we've got VW Beetles. We've got Beetles still in this era. You've got a major hardcore dance routine that she smashes.
Yeah.
You've got an old school breakdown in the music video with some Janet stuff. And she really, you forget how hardcore Janet Jackson was.
Completely.
It just left my head, and I'm sorry that I forgot about it, Janet. Well done.
I will say, I mean, we spoke about Pure and Simple last week from Hearsay, and I bet nobody expected me to say Hearsay during Janet Jackson, but I am going to. I didn't make this point last week because I think we made our point enough. We didn't need to heap any more shit on Hearsay. I found that track so impersonal and so cold. Like, when they were saying, "I'm going to be there for you," I could feel it whizzing past my shoulder. With this, I felt like I was Janet Jackson was right in front of me, and she was saying these to me. Ooh. And it was like there was nobody else. It felt very intimate, and I felt very loved by this track. I mean, the "Tell Me I'm the Only One," I was like, "Fucking yeah, right, I will."
Oh, whatever. No. Yeah. You're gonna be O-towning with Janet Jackson the night, are you, pet?
Oh dear, let's not go there. And finally, given that my previous series winner was Daft Punk "One More Time," this beat that to the Grammy for Best Dance Recording in 2002.
Ooh, and actually, yeah, there's something else coming up too that's a big track that didn't make it to the Billboard number one spot because of this track.
Mmm. 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 Mmm.